بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Alhamdulillah again, brothers and sisters, all praise due to Allah, the creator of all things, the sender of all prophet, and the revealer of all truth. He is Allah who gives knowledge to whom He please, and He will take it back from whoever He please. Guidance is from Allah, and may all of us be guided by Almighty Allah, Rabbul Alameen. Fellow brothers and sisters, we have been discussing about knowledge, the importance of knowledge, the ethic of knowledge, the responsibility of people of knowledge. Many issues that we discussed before we talk about the importance of knowledge. And today we are still continue to talk about the power of the right knowledge. The truth is power, because the truth always penetrates in the heart of the sincere person, and it will stay there. People who are sincere, wherever they are, when they hear the truth, they always respond to it, because the truth is a fitrah, is a sunnatullah, that no sincere heart will reject the truth. So we hope that we are always on the truth and following the truth path. Now, we have been discussing about the truth is always from Allah. Al-haq min rabbik. Allah is the truth, wal-haq, and the truth came from Him. And the Prophet ﷺ will never utter anything except what is right and what is true. This is very clear to us. We all Muslims have the same belief wherever you are. The truth is here, the power of the truth is here to overcome doubtful areas. A lot of people live in doubts today. They are not sure whether this is right or wrong, whether this is halal or haram. Sometimes we are very confused. But when the truth comes, it abolishes all these doubtful areas. That's number one. The truth will give us the yaqeen, the certainty that we know what we are talking about, because we have the truth. But truth must have evidence, bayinat. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to explain, to make it clear to the people, so the people understand what is the true message of Islam. And that's what the Prophet also command all his followers, to only speak the truth. And that's why he said, man kana yu'minu billah wa yawmil akhir falyakul khairan aw liyasmut. Say what is right, what is true. Or you who believe in Allah, and you believe there is a hereafter for you, you must speak out the truth, nothing but the truth. Or silence is always better. So normally in our life today, the public are very confused with many issues, and they are waiting for a verdict, for a fatwa from people of knowledge. And people of knowledge who claim that they are people of knowledge, they are supposed to overcome the doubt that the people are having, the confusion that people are facing, not to create more doubts. Because what Allah says is right, whether you like it or not. Give you one simple example. If Allah said this food is halal, that means it's halal. Even 1 million of people disagree, but still is haq, is true. That's why the concept of truth don't belong to anybody. It belongs to Allah. And we are supposed to accept the truth and convey the truth. So if we fail to do this, brothers and sisters, we have failed ourselves. We have failed Allah and we have failed our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The truth is not here to please anybody. The truth is here to discipline everybody, to educate everyone humbly to accept the truth. And so that everybody will have the right value of life, will have peace. Look at how Allah guide us in seeking the truth. Number one, Allah said, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu in ja'akum fasiqun binaba'in fatabayyan. O you who believe in Allah, if we believe in Allah, whether you are a scholar or you are not yet a scholar, we all are believers. If there's any news or rumors come to you, anybody carry tales, stories to you, the saying of A or B to you, don't ever make any comment or pass any verdict or judgment until fatabayyanu, meaning until we clarify, get the information about the whole issue and look at it with an open mind and open heart under the guidance of the truth that favor nobody. Now, when you are truthful to yourself, brother and sister, there's a lot of benefit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, ittaqu billah wa qulu qawlan sadida. Yuslih lakum a'malakum wa yaghfir lakum zunubakum. Wa man yuti' Allah wa rasulah faqad faza fawzan azima. Allah is telling us, O you who believe in Allah, be faithful, ittaqu billah. Be obedient to Allah and always speak what is right, what is true, so that you can act upon what is right and what is true. So there's no fear in you, nothing for you to hide. Because whatever you say, you must be responsible with your word. You don't twist and turn. Today you say A, tomorrow you say A plus. No, A is A, B is B. Right is right, wrong is wrong. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind us, if we are truthful to Allah, truthful to everybody, we have a lot of peace in our life. To the extent Allah said, I will help you to rectify your problem. Yuslih lakum a'malakum. Whatever you want to do, the blessing of Allah is there, the guidance of Allah is there. He is going to help us to rectify the mistake that we've done. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And Allah said, if you didn't do it purposely, all the wrong thing, the wrong ibadah, the wrong dua, the wrong statement that we have done earlier, Allah will forgive us for that because we are truthful to ourselves. We are coming back to the truth. Because the power of the truth that Allah will erase all our earlier sin because we are ready to repent and come back to the truth. It's like the people who are worshipping other than Allah. When they know what is Islam, what is on, they come back to Allah. They come back to Islam, all the past sins have been erased. This is the power of the right knowledge, the power of following what is right. You don't lose anything. It's a win kind of thing, brothers and sisters. وَيُسْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And Allah is here to forgive us. This is a blessing. Allah is offering His forgiveness to us, and He is offering His help to help us, as long as we must be true to what we say, what we do. Especially when we talk about Islam, the religion that belongs to Allah. We don't have any authority to talk about Islam without going back to the book of Allah. The same goes, we have no right to talk about our Prophet without going back to his Sunnah. If the Prophet never say anything, you cannot say it's a Sunnah. Whether he say or he does it, then you can claim that it's a Sunnah. If not, you cannot say something that you like and say, oh, this is a Sunnah, it's okay. No. The Ummah is very confused, need a lot of guidance. And the guidance is with us as scholars. Just we must be sincere. Not to sacrifice the truth, just to please the people. And sometimes as scholar, you can be easily corrupted by your student, by your followers. Because when your followers grow, they praise you, they admire you so much, shaitan will come in and make you feel so important that you are so pure, you are so right, that nobody is better than you anymore. That's where the shaitan comes in. We must be very careful. Even our Prophet, his Ummah want to praise him so much, admire him, he said, I am Muhammad Rasulullah, the servant of Allah. Don't praise me or honor me like how the early nation have praised Jesus to the extent that Jesus is God, no more a prophet. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to understand the power of the truth. We'll come back after the short break. Alhamdulillah, dear brothers and sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from all the fitna, the misunderstanding. The Ummah is very confused, need a lot of guidance. And the guidance is with us as scholars. Just we must be sincere. Not to sacrifice the truth, just to please the people. And sometimes as scholar, you can be easily corrupted by your student, by your followers. Because when your followers grow, they praise you, they admire you so much, shaitan will come in and make you feel so important that you are so pure, you are so right, that nobody is better than you anymore. That's where the shaitan comes in. We must be very careful. The confusion that we are facing today, and I dare to say it, is because people of knowledge don't take up their responsibility and dare not speak up the truth for the sake of Allah. Everybody have their own agenda, and may Allah forgive them for that. It's time for us as students of knowledge to be very careful in our references, who we ask, and how to ask scholars. Make sure that your question is clear. Don't always come up with a very general kind of question. It can be this, can be that, so that the scholar will be able to explain in more detail to us, so that we can be guided. Because if we are misguided now, we are worried that our generation, our children also be misguided. So we have turned astray because we don't follow the truth. And now we are misleading our children, they will also go astray. So it's very important, don't take this lightly. We always hope that the scholar will start to change. All scholars must use their wisdom, the knowledge that Allah gives them, and nothing more than the Quran and the Sunnah when talking about knowledge. And the Quran is here to clear things, bayan, to explain everything in detail. The Quran is here to show us, furqan, what is right is right, what is wrong is wrong. And we hope that we will do what Allah wants us to do. If we obey Allah, وَمَنْ يُتِعِ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ, at the end of the day, Allah said, we will gain a lot of reward from Allah. فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. It's a great success. Because when Allah loves us, brothers and sisters, Allah protects us. Not only when we are alive, He will protect us even after we are dead. People will remember the good thing that we have done. But if we betray the message of Islam just to please the people, for our own gain, a worldly gain, you may get what you want in this world. But when you die, we are going to face a lot of trial from Allah, because we have mispresented Islam, we have misguided a lot of people, we create a lot of confusion, and we make fitna to the good people around us. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, brothers and sisters, to make sure that when we want to ask any kind of Islamic verdict in the future, ask Allah to guide you. Oh Allah, guide us. Show us the right person for us to refer to. But Allah have given us guidance, brothers and sisters. Don't be confused again. A right person will not give his opinion to give you a verdict. He will have, فَتَبَيَّنُوا الْبَيَانُ, means he must have hard evidence. My humble experience in life, I've seen a lot of people claim themselves as scholars, known as a scholar among the community, giving statement that is very, very dangerous and very un-Islamic. No basis at all. And sometimes they dare to say, yeah, it's in the Quran, yes, it's the Hadith. The public may not know the difference because they don't read the Quran every day. They are not exposed to the Sunnah. But I have that experience. I cannot keep quiet when they say this. If they say this is an opinion, I just leave it, because an opinion is an opinion. Everybody can have an opinion. But when they say, yeah, it's in the Sunnah, the Prophet, then I'm going to ask them. I will use my wisdom not to bring them down too. I say, Oh, Mufti, I did heard somebody say this. I was checking in the book of hadith, but I never found it. This hadith, that hadith, I never found that kind of saying, that kind of hadith. But I know this is a popular saying among some scholars. Then only I say, oh, yeah, yeah, this is an opinion from some scholars. Now, this happened in front of me. This is my experience. Because these people are scholars. People recognize them as scholars. They are so confident of what they want to say, they thought that all the people who question them are ignorant people. And that's also a very dangerous feeling. Don't think that the people who are learning with you are ignorant. They may have knowledge. They just want to check whether you have the right information or not. When slowly they will lose their respect to you, and they will disrespect you because you have betrayed them. Because they want you to guide them, but you misguide them. Passing statement, there's no evidence at all, and you say, yeah, the Prophet said this, the Prophet said that. Give you one simple example of how confused the public can be. Sometimes, people want to make dua, prayers, asking for rain, which is good. The Prophet have taught us how to pray, to ask for rain, by performing turqa, prayer, istisqa, and give a short khutbah. There's an adab. But some people will say, let us perform prayer for the rain, and they name the prayer Salatul Hajjah, example. When did the Prophet taught us to pray Salatul Hajjah, to ask for rain? And a lot of people just follow blindly because of good faith. People love to ask Allah for something. They're drought for months. People need rain. But the Prophet have taught us how to perform the prayer to ask for rain. Why can't we just follow? If you don't know how to pray, let people who know to lead, or just make dua. Don't have to make salah al-istisqa. But don't replace salah al-istisqa with a new form of prayer. This is misguided, and it's very dangerous. It's just like what's happening in the Muslim marriage today. How many percent that we are following the Sharia in the Islamic marriage? The ijab, kabul, niqah, walima, maybe. The rest, we go haywire. We forget all our values. We mess up everything. Everything that is haram become permissible at the day of our children's marriage. Now, what kind of message are we going to deliver to the people? To tell them this is okay, what is haram is halal. There are even food, packed food in Europe. They have an issue. They have a halal logo, but the content of the meat, they say, they are pork. They're very confused. There's a lot of confusion going on, so it's time for us to sit down, to guide the ummah, to unite the ummah, not to create more division among ourselves, where this is forbidden by Allah. Allah has said, وَاَتَّصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَحْصَبْتُمْ بِنِعْمَةِ إِخْوَانِكُمْ. Allah commands us to hold fast to the teaching of Islam, the Quran and the Sunnah, to the rope of Allah, and do not be divided anymore. Because before that, everybody is so divided. Islam can pull us together and tie us down and make us one strong ummah. So we should not allow the division to take place. But what is happening, we become so judgmental, keep on giving the wrong verdict and create more confusion, and we love to divide the ummah. It's divide and rule. This is all very un-Islamic approach, and it's very dangerous. Because Allah said, once upon a time, when we don't have guidance, we are like enemy to one another. Because everybody have their own way of thinking, own way of valuing things. We feel very sad. But Islam unites us, that we don't pass judgment without the evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah. When the judgment is from Quran and Sunnah, it's final. Everybody humbly must obey what Allah and the Prophet said. Not to please the people, to disobey Allah. And we know that the Prophet ﷺ have given us guidance, masha'Allah. La ta'atul makhluk fi ma'asyatillah. We can obey anybody, our parent, our scholar, our leader, as long as they do not call us to disobey Allah. Everything that we do with human, there is a limit. And that limit is very, very important. We know what Allah and the Prophet have reminded us. I show you a simple example. The beauty of Islam. Allah said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَى. All believers are like a family, brothers and sisters. إِخْوَى. And the Prophet said, كُلُّ مُسْلِمْ عَلَى مُسْلِمْ حَرَامٌ دَامُهُ وَمَالُهُ وَإِرْضُهُ. All Muslim to another Muslim is sacred. What is sacred? Their blood, their property, and their dignity. We must learn how to respect each other, honor each other, protect each other, help each other. This basic teaching of Islam is not being honored today. We are abusing each other, attacking each other, backstabbing each other, fitna each other, gossip against each other. We just love to do things that is the opposite of what Allah and the Prophet want us to do. Now, if this kind of activity is being done by the public, we can still forgive them because they are ignorant about a lot of things. But if this thing is done by scholars, this is the great fitna. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sin, brother and sister. Save us from this great fitna by at least we know what to do as a Muslim, where to refer for a verdict, and we know that there must be evidence from Quran and Sunnah. Quran and Sunnah is sure to protect you and protect me from being misled by people and from going out from the truth of Islam. May Allah guide us, forgive us, and may Allah protect us and our family, our children from all the great fitan that we are exposed to. Amin, Ya Rabbil Alamin. وبالله التوفيق والأقري دعوانا والحمد لله بالعالمين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت استغفرك وأتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
هذا القرآن يوحدنا لطريق الخير يوجهنا الله تعالى أنزله ورسول الله معلمنا ورسول الله